So, as you all know that half-yearly exams are going to begin, so let's do the revision of the lesson. Today we'll begin with the lesson Ranga's marriage, and this is from the book Snapshot. It's the supplementary reader, and in this Ranga's marriage, you may be remembering, or if you haven't listened to the explanation, or if you haven't read the book, then you should know that the story begins with the part in which the narrator over here is Shyama. He is the narrator, and he says that when he was living in a village, there the people did not know English, and they spoke in their own mother tongue, and the English words were not spoken by any of the people, and even he did not know about them. And one day he found a crowd was there around Rangappa's house. This is Ranga, who is also called Ranganatha. His house was crowded, and the narrator asked one of the person why people are gathered over here. So he said, "You don't know why you have come over here." So he didn't say anything, he just kept quiet. And later on he came to know that he had returned from Bangalore after completing his studies. So people wanted to know, was there any change in him after returning from Bangalore? And his father was the first person to send his son to Bangalore to study, and so it was a very exciting moment for the village people, and everybody wanted to see him, and people were thinking that he must have changed his caste also. So one of the lady, she went near him, she touched his chest, and she found the thread that you have put, what to call, that thread was over there. So she said that he did not change his caste, he is the same person. And then everybody was very much happy, and then after that people started moving away from his house, and the narrator was still standing over there. And when everybody went off, he greeted him, and he asked, "How are you?" So he greeted him and said, "I'm okay, and how are you, uncle?" And then few conversation was going on with them, and then the narrator asked him, "When are you thinking to marry?" So he said, "I am not going to marry, because I want the person whom I love. So without knowing anybody, I cannot marry." Then he started telling about different things, different stories. So the narrator, he was determined that he will look for a girl for him. And then he remembered Rama Rao. In his house, his relative's daughter had come, and her name was Ratna. Rama Rao's house, Ratna was there. She was his niece, and she had moved from city over there, as her parents had died, and she was all alone. So she had come over here, and she was living with them, and she was quite grown up, and she used to sing beautifully. And so he decided that now he'll try to make a match of Ranga with Ratna. So he tried to play a trick. One day he said to Rama Rao's wife, that you send Ratna to my place, and then I will send buttermilk for you. So she said okay, and next day Ratna went to the narrator's house, and he told her, "You go and sit inside, and you just sing a song, whichever song you like. And by the time the narrator, he called for Ranga also. And when she was still singing, Ranga, he arrived over there and he was surprised to hear the beautiful song that was coming out from the house, the sound. And then he just tried to peep inside who was there, and as he peeped in, the shadow, he was in the sun, so shadow fell on the ground, on the floor of the room, and Ratna saw somebody was there, so she kept quiet. And then both of them looked at each other and she felt shy and she ran away from there. And by the time this fellow came in, the narrator came in and he started talking to him. And then when Ranga asked him about the girl, he said that she is married, and so he felt very bad. He did not say anything, and after that he said, okay, I'm going. And then the narrator, he went, and as you all have seen in the Hindi films, that the hero, he goes to the Pandit priest and he tells him he, all these things you have to say, kundali, undali, or whatever you all have in the to set the marriage and all. So he went and he tutored the Pandit what all he had to say. So the Pandit was quite satisfied that he's ready now. And then next day, both were talking, the narrator and Ranga, both were talking, and the narrator asked him, ki, why you're feeling so sad, why you're upset, come let's go to the Pandit and then he'll tell you what all reasons are there behind it. So they went over there, and the Pandit, he greeted them, and he started, the narrator asked Pandit ki, tell his future of faith, whatever problems he have in his life, and let's see whether your forecast is correct or not. So he said okay, and then he said something is wrong with you, and something is haunting you, something is there in your mind that is troubling you. And he said, maybe one of the girl, you're thinking of a girl and that is reminding you and making you feel sorry and unhappy. So he said yes, and then he tried to find the name, and he said something that is found in the ocean. So the narrator said it's Kamal or something like that. And later on the word Ratna came, and as the word Ratna came, and it was the name of the girl, Ratna, so the Ranga's face was lit up, and they found that he was really in love with her. He wanted to know about her, he wanted to marry her, and later on they got married. And one day Ranga, he called the narrator to his house, and after many days, when he went over there, and as he went inside, a small baby, he ran and he came and caught the narrator. And the narrator, he asked the child, what is his name? So he said, my name is Shyama. And the narrator, he asked Ranga why he kept his name Shyama. He is so beautiful, he is good, fair looking, so you shouldn't have kept the name Shyama. So he said that I got, you were the inspiration in my life, and because of you, I found this girl, I got married, and so that's why I have kept my child your name. I have given the child your name as Shyama. And then the narrator, he put a gold chain round the neck of the baby, and then he had his lunch over there, dinner, food he had, and then he went off. So this is the story. Ramasma. marriage. And as you will read the lesson, you will come across many of the conversation that is there between the narrator and the Ranga. So you'll come to know all those things. So it's better you read the lessons thoroughly, because everything will come from inside of the lesson. So that's all for today, children. Good day and